what you saw Mazda do in 2013 with our SkyActiv diesel power plant and our Mazda 6 sports cars in the Grand Am series was win 9 races and win the Manufacturers Championship. What you see behind me is really step 2, and that is our opportunity to take the learnings from last year and move up to the prototype category in the all-new Tudor United Sports Car Racing Championship. We're very pleased to take another step in our journey. This is really a 5-year journey. It's a big challenge for us. The 2.2-liter diesel that we ran last year certainly got us to where we needed to be, but now we're gonna ask even more of the engine and the entire package as we tackle races like the 24 hours at Daytona, the 6 hours at Watkins Glen, the Petit Le Mans, and certainly the 12 hours of Sebring. One of Mazda's key testimonies is to race what we sell. So last year's engine was truly production-based, with over 50% of the engine being directly from the road car. So plenty of learnings there about the limitations of the OEM equipment, the stock engine parts that we used in the Mazda 6s last year. We're still at that same level of using production components in the prototype category. Certainly by the rules, we need to in the cylinder head and the engine block. But we've taken steps in the pistons by running steel pistons in the new championship in 2014. And obviously the packaging in a chassis of this type, the Mazda prototype, will be a lot different in terms of cooling, and we're making a lot more torque. So the transmission is being asked to do a lot more than it did in 2013. 2014 represents a new era of sports car racing in the United States, a rebirth of sorts, and gives all manufacturers and partners of the series the opportunity to come with a single focus, both in their investment and in their messaging. We can tell a great story about technology, advanced fuels, advanced engines, to a broader audience, to certainly the sports car enthusiasts that have been following series for decades, but taking the new platform and giving us a chance to make what we do on the racetrack tie directly to road car technologies. Several of the cars that used to compete in sports car racing are obviously not going to be able to compete, like the well-loved P1 cars. But in this new series, we all have a new platform now to bring the best that we have, many of them production-based engines that can go out in a really balanced way and compete in the best and longest endurance races in the world. For Mazda, the opportunity to bring the SkyActiv diesel technology is directly related to what we've done with SkyActiv technology overall. That is a new approach to building a road car. Lighter weight components, more rigid and strengthened chassis, lighter weight and more efficient engines and transmissions. In the case of diesel, it certainly on the racetrack gives us a fuel efficiency or a fuel range story. So in the case of a typical race in the new Tudor series, we're going to be able to go about 30 to 40 minutes longer than our competition. That is a huge advantage for us. We may not be the fastest car by lap time, but certainly that fuel story relates to road car technology.